Should you eat paleo or vegan? Should you do CrossFit or bodybuilding? Is wine good or bad for your heart? We are bombarded by varying perspectives on a variety of topics on a daily basis. You need to sort out what's real and what's nonsense. I'll show you how to do exactly that. What's going on, guys? Dr. Jubal from MedSchoolInsiders.com. That's right, it's Dr. Jubal and no longer Dr. J. I came out with my real identity and the truth behind my struggles and my story in a recent video on the Life of a Surgeon vlog channel. Link is in the description below. Many of our beliefs are plain wrong, not based in science or fact, but rather in anecdotes, word of mouth, or misinformation from seemingly trusted sources. It's important to understand that many of our beliefs are socially constructed. As humans, we are incredibly malleable in what we believe and how we perceive the world. The influence of others holds tremendous weight. Homo sapiens have evolved since our hunter-gatherer times to follow the herd because falling out of line could lead to being ostracized, which would ultimately mean the end of the road for one's reproductive fitness. However, this desire to fit in and the resultant homogenization of our perspectives often does more harm than good in our current age. Throw in the power of clicks, money, and advertising with companies fighting for our attention, and it's no surprise that it's incredibly tough to determine fact from fiction. In order to sift through all the noise and hyperbolic sensationalism and figure out the truth, we must question our own beliefs and values to ensure that we have deliberately chosen them and not simply blindly believed what we have been told. Let's start with the pinnacle of progress and understanding, scientific research. Now, many of us turn to the most recent journal articles to help guide our beliefs and ways of living. However, to get the most out of research requires a nuanced understanding of not only the study design, but also the subject matter, funding, and study limitations. One of the best ways to witness the importance of these factors is by turning to nutrition science, which still remains highly controversial. One week it sounds like paleo is the best diet, the next week vegan, and the week after that Mediterranean. Here's an example. In 2014, Bazzano et al. Published a randomized trial comparing low-carb to low-fat diets. Many interpreted the findings as a landslide victory, proving that a low-carb diet is superior. The low-carb diet, after all, showed an increase in HDL, which is your good cholesterol, and greater weight loss. This is a randomized trial, though, so it must be a good study, right? Not so fast. It is true that randomized prospective trials are better than retrospective trials, which analyze data from the past and look for correlations. However, by understanding the subject material and the study limitations, it becomes apparent that like many nutritional studies, this one is far from perfect. The study relied on self-reported dietary information, which is prone to recall bias. Dietitians were not blinded, there were no cardiovascular disease endpoints, the low-fat diet was really just a regular fat diet, and fiber intake was less than half of the recommended amount. Additionally, HDL, which is your good cholesterol, functions to transport cholesterol from the periphery to your liver. Increasing the amount of fats and cholesterol you eat will require a greater amount of HDL. If you have more garbage, you need more garbage trucks. It does not necessarily make you healthier. It's equally important to pay attention to who funds the study. Data, but even more so common sense, indicates that industry funding is associated with pro-industry conclusions. The Vox recently came out with an excellent article explaining how the chocolate industry has funded hundreds of studies that promote chocolate as a health food. Is chocolate actually good for your health when unbiased studies are examined? The too long didn't read is no. But cocoa-based products with little or no added sugar or fat do seem beneficial. For those of you who want a more scientific analysis, check out the systematic review by Hooper et al. That essentially said the same thing. Many of your beliefs have no scientific backing. Now let's be real, none of us actually go to the primary literature for everything. Nor should we. Your beliefs don't all require scientific backing, but they do all require a healthy dose of skepticism. If I asked you how much water you should drink in a day, you may suggest 8 glasses. The 8 glasses of water recommendation actually has minimal scientific basis and can be traced back to a 1921 paper where the author measured his own urine and sweat to determine that he lost approximately 3% of his body weight in water per day, which is approximately 8 cups. I'm not sure about you, but basing humanity's water intake recommendation off the results of one man seems misled. Your belief of whether or not there is a God definitely is not based on scientific fact. People have varying opinions, and it's critical to be aware that just because you do or do not believe in one thing doesn't mean that another person's opinion is not valid. This is even more so important when your beliefs aren't easily proven one way or another, such as with regards to religion. To sift through the misinformation, it's essential to practice critical thinking. What is critical thinking? It's essentially the skill of absorbing important information and using that to form a decision or opinion of your own, rather than just reciting what others say. First, determine what is important. Not all things require this level of analysis. When deciding which movie you're going to watch tonight, maybe you don't have to be 100% certain on which movie would be the best for your current mood and time allocation. So first, determine what is important for you to understand on a deeper level. To start, any behavior you are changing that significantly affects your health, life, or well-being should require a deeper understanding where you have practiced critical thinking. As a doctor, I would argue that anything affecting your health, like deciding on which diet or exercise routine to pursue, requires critical thinking and analysis. Step 2, pay attention to the right details. In this day and age, we are exposed to an all-time high of information. Information overload. Determining which facts are relevant and which are irrelevant will serve you well. First, question the source. As we have already gone over, sources are not always reliable. Thinking about who benefits from a statement can also help you shift your perspective and view the topic in a more objective way. Step 3, challenge the argument. The best way to challenge the argument is by asking the right questions. What is the counterargument? No argument is bulletproof, and it's your duty to question what you are told, to see the other side, and to understand both sides of the coin. Step 4, be wary of your own confirmation bias. Rather than question our beliefs, it is human nature that we want to reinforce our current views. You may find yourself reading articles that align with your beliefs, but why not learn about the opposing viewpoint? Understanding both sides will not only guide you closer to the truth, but you will also have a stronger backing and argument supporting your conclusion. If you find yourself repulsed by a certain point of view in an argument, chances are you are being close-minded and not objective. Take a step back, acknowledge your bias, and reapproach the situation with curiosity rather than confirming your existing beliefs. Thank you all so much for watching, and special shout out to my Patreon supporters that help make videos like these possible. If you liked the video, make sure you press that like button, hit subscribe if you have not already, and I will see you guys in that next one.